everyone and welcome to another video. If you are new to my channel, hi, my name is Brenda and today I'm really excited to share with you the new Glam Polish Halloween collection. So this has been a very highly anticipated collection and I was very lucky to grab my favorites. So this collection had a lot of nail polishes, but as usual I only picked up those polishes that I knew I was going to wear. So I ended up picking up 6 polishes from the entire collection. This is actually the first time that I get to try this brand. I have never tried their polishes before, so I'm not really familiar with the formula, but the polishes seem very cute, so hopefully they will work out well for me. I want to say that this collection, as I said already, was highly anticipated, so these polishes sold out really fast, and if you were not there the minute they were released, you probably wouldn't have been able to pick up the ones that you wanted. So as soon as the sale went live, I just went straight to those that I wanted to get, and I was able to check out and successfully purchase my favorites. Anyways, that's a long story, but we are going to move on. Right after the intro, I'm going to be sharing with you a close-up look of each nail polish. We're going to be talking about the formula, the application, and as any other review here in my channel, I'll be telling you the things that I like and the things that I do not like, if any. So if you don't want to miss any of those details, please keep watching. But before we continue, please don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any of my videos.
So I'm gonna start with this polish right here just because I have mixed feelings about it, and as we move on I'm going to be telling you which ones were the favorite ones from the one I purchased and which ones I was not that convinced about. Many of you have been telling me how to apply this type of jelly flaky polishes. Usually you are supposed to go with very thin layers, which I was trying to do at the very beginning, but the formula was so runny that I kept getting a lot in my nail, so it got a little bit messy. First coat wasn't perfect by any means, though I do think I got pretty good coverage on it. I did try the second coat and it didn't give me full coverage either. I was also going with a little bit of a thin layer on this one just to build it up, but as you can see there's one little spot on the front of my nail, and if I kept going on with the brush I was just going to remove it. So the application on this one, I feel like it was a little bit tricky, and once again the formula was very runny, so I did have to work with it very carefully. By the third coat, luckily I was able to get full coverage, which is really good because honestly, 3 coats is like pushing it for me, so I wasn't really happy about applying a third coat. I know a lot of people doesn't really mind, but I just think about the time when I had to take this off. If I had this in a full manicure, I know that after it dries, the removal is going to be painful. Alright, so after I show you that lots of glitter, I'm going to show you this beautiful green polish that has some of that goldish shimmer. And this is something that I really liked about this collection, is how many different finishes were in it. They were not limiting to like a certain type of colors or finishes, so that was really nice. For my surprise, the coverage on the first coat was very, very thin. So I was really not expecting for it to give me full coverage on the first one anyways, but I was hoping that it would give me full coverage on the second one. However, that was not the case and I still had to apply a third one to get there. Anyhow, I feel like this shade is totally worth it just because I find it so unique. It's green, but it also has that shimmer, and I'm gonna show you how it looks under the flashlight here at the end so you can see it. So it's definitely something very unique and I'm honestly so happy that I got it. Next, I'm gonna show you my favorite one from the collection. I do have a second favorite one, but that's gonna be for later. I do feel like this one is the one that I like the most from all of the polishes that I bought. And this one is a brown nail polish, but as you can see, it has some holo glitter and it also has some shift, which you are going to see in the end as well, but I think you can kind of catch it here. Once again, I do find that very consistent on the formula of these polishes is that all of them are very sheer. You can see here the coverage on the first coat wasn't the best, but as I applied the second one, this one did build up really, really nicely, and I was actually able to get away with only applying two coats, which is perfect for me. So as you can see here, the color really builds to that gorgeous brown reddish tone, and I just cannot express how much I like this polish because it just looks stunning under regular lighting, and so it does under flashlight. So this one is one of those that I know I'm going to be reaching for whenever it comes to fall manicures, and I'm just super excited that I bought it and that I was lucky enough to grab it. So here are all first three polishes. You can see them all side by side. I don't think there is need to compare them because all of them were so unique. Alright, so we're halfway there already. Time goes by so fast whenever you're swatching polishes. Anyways, this one is another one that I really, really liked, and probably one that I was the most excited about. I mentioned this in my unboxing video when I first showed you all these polishes. I was really looking for a brown glitter polish. So this is obviously not like a chunky type of glitter, but I think you get the idea. I just wanted brown glitter. Like, I wasn't even going for the hollow because it actually has a little bit of hollow glitter in there. I mainly just wanted brown glitter. So this one actually looked really nice. So usually I don't know how brown polishes will look on my brown skin tone. It varies a lot. It depends on the tones and everything, but this one right here, I feel like it was just perfect for me. And this is really all I was looking for in a brown glitter, and I'm just so excited that I got it. The formula was also fantastic. As you saw, two coats were perfect and I got the most beautiful coverage. Alright, so this one right here was just another one that I do have a lot of mixed feelings about, and I should have known better when I picked it. So first, as you can see, this one has a blue base, which you already know I really like blue. I do like the blue or greenish flakes, however, I don't know how I feel about the purple or pink glitters. I don't know, maybe I would have just liked it to have the flakes and not the pink glitter, but you know, as I said, I should have known better when I picked it, so I wasn't really convinced. And once again, the formula was sheer on the first coat. I was trying to go with thin layers, but this one was also very runny. But overall, I do feel like this one gave me a better coverage on the second coat, maybe because it was a blue base compared to the other one that I swatched at first. So I don't know, this one, once again, I do have mixed feelings about it. I don't hate it, but I don't love it either. So maybe it will just grow on me, and I don't know, I'll just figure it out the day I wear it. And this one right here was my second favorite from the collection. This one, since I saw the pictures, I just knew that I was going to love it. So once again, really excited that I was able to get my hands on it. The reason why I like this one so much is because to me, all those different colors of flakies look just like confetti, like it's a party, and it looks so nice. I know the first coat wasn't, once again, the greatest. Very sheer coat. I had to go with a very thin coat and build up the color. The formula was also very runny on this one, so it did get a little bit messy. But on the second coat, I got full coverage, and you can really see how beautiful it looks. All those different colors of flakies and glitters against the black base is just pure perfection, and I'm honestly so happy with this polish. Like, I just love it so much. I do feel like this one though is going to be one of those that's going to be really hard to remove. Might be that type of polish that gets stuck in the cotton ball whenever you're trying to get it off, but I'm willing to take the pain because it's just so, so pretty. And here you have the last three polishes that I swatched. You can see a bit of a difference between all of them. So sadly, all these polishes were limited edition, but if you still want to check out the Glam Polish website and see all the amazing polishes that they have in there, feel free to do so. I'm going to leave the link to shop below.
Alright, now that you have seen my swatches, I want to know which one was your favorite from my picks, and also if you were able to grab any of these polishes. And there is also something that I want to ask, and this is a genuine question because I don't know why now polish brands do these, but so far as I know, this collection was limited editions, and my question really is, why now polish brands do these? Because I feel like if they know that the collection was very popular last year, maybe they would want to keep it it and maybe just restock it at least once or two times. But I have seen from people reviewing from this nail polish brand that they come up with trios every month, and then those three polishes are limited edition. So I'm just curious to know why, if a nail polish is selling good, you wouldn't want to bring it back. I don't know what's the marketing behind it. Like, I get it, like, you hype people that they are limited edition so they will get them, but at the same time, wouldn't it be rough to come up with different nail polishes every month instead of just keeping some favorites for people to pick? I don't know. So if you have any information about it, please share it with me in the comments too, because I'm honestly very curious to know. Alright, so that is everything that I wanted to share and ask today. So thank you so much for watching once again. If you like my videos, please don't forget to like and leave a comment. The engagement always helps my channel so much. Also, if you're interested in seeing swatches of other indie brands, I'm going to be leaving some links down below so you can check them out. Please don't forget to subscribe, because I share a lot of swatches. I also share nail art occasionally, and I also upload 2 times a week, so you can enjoy some fun content, everything that comes to nail polish and nail art related. That'll be it for today. I will see you on the next one. Goodbye.